Welcome everybody to this week's Better Branding Tip. We're going to talk about why your website load speed matters today. Check it out. Did you know that 1 in 4 people would actually leave a website if it takes longer than 4 seconds for that website to load? And that actually even a 1 second delay in load speed on a website can decrease customer satisfaction by a whopping 16%. That's crazy. There's actually a term for this, and it's called bounce rate in the industry. You may have heard that before. So that is, how long will people wait around before leaving your website, or how long are they staying on your website before leaving? That's called bounce rate, and it's an important metric when you're talking about customer satisfaction and your user experience. This is one of the reasons why it's really important that you choose the right company to build and manage your website for you. They need to be well versed in a lot of different things, and you need to make sure they actually are optimizing these 5 areas of your website in order to ensure that your load speed is appropriate for your visitors. The first area that needs to be optimized is your actual hosting environment. So it's not enough to just build a fancy looking site and a brand new site if you're gonna host it on a piece of crap server, right? Your server needs to be up to par as well, and who you host with matters. Some companies don't offer both hosting and web development services. There's some companies that do one or the other. We here at 321 Rust do offer both the web development and design services and the hosting services. And we find it's really important to make sure your hosting is appropriate. We've had it happen to us, and I know a lot of other developers and agencies that it's happened to them, where they create this gorgeous website for a client, but then the client wants to host it themselves on some cheap server, and it's not enough. It can't handle the bandwidth that they're having, their site traffic, the uptime is off. Maybe they're bundled together with other people on a server, and if you're bundled with the wrong person or the wrong couple different companies on a server, it's going to affect your website load speed. So that's the very first thing, is making sure your hosting environment is appropriate and optimized for your website and the people who use it. The second element that needs to be optimized is your media. So that's your images, your graphics, any video that you have on your website and in the website design itself. You want to make sure that those things are optimized. You can have a lot of images on your website and it can look gorgeous, but those images need to be optimized. And there's a handful of ways you can do that in the development side of things, but also in the hosting as well. There's ways you can optimize images to where when you upload them, they actually basically shrink them, for lack of a better word, not necessarily in size, but in the file size, so that what's actually being loaded in front of the customer is actually a little bit of a smaller size item. You know, it may not be a 1 gigabyte item that they're looking at, which would be crazy, or that'd be way too big. Or it may not be like a 212 megabyte item, but it's actually a 212 kilobyte item that they're actually looking at. So that's what's loading in. And so I know that's a little technical, but when you actually optimize the media that you're using in a website, it will greatly affect your load speed. The third item that needs to be optimized is your plugins. Now, a lot of people know the word plugins, but don't quite understand what they do. Well, that's not this video today, but what I can tell you is that plugins sometimes need to be updated weekly, sometimes monthly, sometimes annually. It just depends on the plugin and what it does, what service it helps your site perform, and also who makes that plugin and all those kind of things. There's a lot that go into it. And also, just because a plugin needs to be updated doesn't mean it can be. Sometimes you'll update a plugin before your actual theme or your WordPress itself can actually take that update. And if you do it in the wrong order, you can break something on your website. So once again, it's important to work with professionals who understand when to update a plugin, because just because it needs to be updated or you have this little icon on the back end of your website that says update me, doesn't mean it can be updated that day. And so timing is important with all of that. Understanding those elements with plugins can help optimize your site for load speed. The fourth item that needs to be looked at is you need to be able to optimize websites for certain browsers. I had a client recently that was using Microsoft Internet Explorer to browse with on their computer. If you're using Internet Explorer, you need to stop. Stop now. You should have stopped a year ago, but stop now. Stop using Internet Explorer. It's obsolete. It's no longer supported. It's a piece of crap. And if you're looking at a website on Internet Explorer, you're not going to see anything that is appropriate. You're going to see a couple things that make sense, but most of it will just be completely broken. And that's because it's not supported. Edge came out, and that's E-D-G-E. Microsoft Edge came out, and that's an appropriate browser you can use. Other common ones are Firefox, Chrome, which I prefer to use, as well as Safari for you Mac users out there who love your Safari one. I love Mac, but I still love to use Chrome myself for a handful of reasons, and there's nothing necessarily wrong with Firefox or Safari either. I don't have a lot of experience using Edge as a consumer, but we definitely, when we create websites, we want to make sure they're optimized for those different browsers so that no matter who the user is and what browser they're using, that they can see your site appropriately and that there's no broken elements on that. But Internet Explorer, it's going to be broken on because that's old, outdated stuff. The fifth and final item that needs to be optimized when it comes to developing a website that loads quickly is mobile responsiveness. You want to make sure that your site is mobile responsive in this day and age. We all know probably by now that most people that are looking at your website are actually going to be on a mobile device, be that a phone or a tablet. And obviously there's plenty of people that still use desktops and laptops. And so making sure that your website looks good on all those different devices, it's going to help with load speed. It's also going to help with the user experience. If your site isn't mobile responsive, you need to fix that. And it's probably going to look like getting a whole new website, but that's okay. It doesn't have to be painful. It can be a pleasant experience if you work with the right company. And actually, we did a video on that. You can check it out here, which talks about why a website development process can be painful or pleasant. So check that video out. Because you want to make sure you're working with the right company so it isn't painful. But having a website that's not mobile responsive is painful for the user. They cannot use your website appropriately. They cannot navigate it appropriately. And it really is outdated for you to have that. And so make sure you update that. And so those are the five things that need to be optimized in order to help load time and your user experience when it comes to people actually wanting to stay on your website, actually deciding to choose you instead of your competition. It's really important that these things be addressed when you're developing a new website.